Surigao del Sur, 2nd District Representative Johnny Pimentel is supposed to join us now on the line. All right, I think we have. Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, I can hear you. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir, and thank you for joining us. Has this decision somehow, you know, for you, been well thought of? I mean, considering that previous hearings in Congress already put forth the opinion that a provisional authority to operate is in fact not unique, that it could be granted to other broadcast institutions who are still having their franchises deliberated on in Congress. Why couldn't it apply to ABS-CBN now?
Yes, that's to say, I was really surprised when NTC issued a cease and desist order, because it has already happened before, where in some of the franchises were expired, but they were allowed to operate. Now, take for the case of the CBCP franchise. Nag-expire na yung franchise nila, but they were allowed to operate.
Mm-hmm.
Take the case of Smart and also of AT&T. So, why single out ABS-CBN?
Mm-hmm.
And if you recall, before the recess of Congress, the Senate already passed a resolution in joining NTC to issue a provisional authority.
Mm-hmm.
And in Congress, right after the hearing, if you recall, that was on March 11, I believe, Speaker Caetano and together with our chairman, Franz Alvarez, wrote a letter to NTC, again, expressing their sentiment that NTC should issue a provisional authority.
Mm.
But I believe this is an offshoot, itong cease and desist order of the pronouncement or the statement of the OSG Calida.
Mm.
Because andun sa statement niya, meron siyang said doon that it will file a case for those who will issue a provisional authority. Siguro that was one of the reason or the main reason why NTC issued the desist order. I believe that today is a very sad day for us Filipinos, because ABS-CBN has been in the forefront of disseminating information with regard to this pandemic. Sana naman dapat hindi nila denying na ngayon sila mag-cease and desist order. I mean, let us set aside politics. Unahin na muna natin ito. Ako mismo, I get information on a day-to-day basis from ABS-CBN on their day-to-daily blow-by-blow account of what is happening, especially with the government updates.
Mm.
And then aside from that, we have seen that ABS-CBN is doing its part in helping our constituents. If I'm not mistaken, through Pagtawid ng Pag-ibig, you have already released 300 million pesos. Sana naman pinatapos na muna natin itong crisis bago ilabas yung cease and desist order. We have so many problems already that we should face another problem, itong franchise. Bakit single out ABS-CBN? It was done before. There were so many franchises that were allowed to operate without even the expiration of their franchise. Eh, bakit itong ABS-CBN hindi naman pagbigyan?
Congressman Johnny, pasensya na po, ano, matanong ko lang. Kapag po ba naglabas ko na rin ng opinion na ganito at yung Office of the Solicitor General, may kasama pa pong banta ito, no? Maaari daw nilang kasuhan kung sino mang kawaninan ng DOJ at NTC na magbigay ng provisional authority. Sa palagay po ba ninyo, kung merong kalabisan, di umano, yung ganitong mga pagbabanta ng Office of the Solicitor General, ay meron din po bang magiging parang appropriate sanction sa kanya kapag kunwari lumabas na he was actually exceeding the authority given to him at hindi niya na-recognize yung authority ng NTC na magbigay ng provisional authority?
Yes, I think so. Well, depende na yan, because OSG is under, of course, the Executive Department. No?
Mm.
So, of course, we already know very well that whatever sanction will be given will also be coming from the chief executive.
Mm.
But I believe that what the opinion of the OSG is not proper at this point in time, because there were threats. Pwede naman yung sabihin na, okay, based on some legalities that NTC cannot issue. Hmm. Eh, bakit lalagyan pa niya doon ng threat that if ever na mag-issue kayo, ipapailan ko pa kayo ng kaso. Mukhang pinipersonal na niyang ABS-CBN on that note, hindi po ba? Dapat eh, if you will release a statement, you will base it on legal opinion or legalities. Mm. Eh bakit may threat pa doon na kung pag if you issue a provisional order, I will file a case at you, against you. So I believe this is the main reason why NTC issued this cease and desist order. Kasi ayaw nila mapailan sila ng kaso. Especially coming from the OSG, wherein NTC also part of the executive department.
Congressman Johnny, ano, balikan natin yung nakaraang hearing na sa Senado at sa Kongreso na na-raise din po yung mga akusasyon ni Solicitor General Calida kontra sa ABS-CBN. Meron pong yung mga sinasabi niya na hindi nakapagbayad ng buwis. Meron yung pag-ooperate daw ng pay-per-view na hindi otorisado. Lahat po yan sinagot na rin po punto por punto ng mga ehekutibo ng ABS-CBN sa Kamara at sa Senado, at tinanggap naman po yung sagot din po ng mga opisyal ng ABS-CBN na pawang tama naman yung naging depensa laban sa mga akusasyong ito. Sa palagay niyo po ba sa ngayon yung mga akusasyong yun ay kailangan pa rin bigyan ng halaga ng NTC, gayong pabulaan na naman ang mga ito ng sapat na paliwanag doon sa mga hearing ng Kamara at ng Senado?
Actually, kataka-taka talaga yung decision ng NTC ngayon, because if you recall, during the hearing of the ABS-CBN last March 11, I was there, I attended. And in fact, I asked the question doon sa NTC, so based on the DOJ opinion, will you issue provisional authority? And they said yes. Then all of a sudden, ngayon, about face sila. All of a sudden. So, along the way, something really pushed the decision to issue this order. At saka, sabi ko nga, mukhang pinipersonal na ni OSG Calida ang ABS-CBN nito. Kasi, dati pa nga, sabi ko, meron namang in-issue, na-expire na ng mga franchise. Why they were allowed? There was already in short a precedent. Meron ng precedent na inallow ng NTC mag-operate yung ibang franchise na expired. E bakit itong ABS-CBN hindi inallow? Yun ang tanong ko. And I think I don't know the reason why OSG Calida is meddling into this franchise when in fact it is the authority or power of Congress to grant, to revoke any franchise. Bakit na pinapakalaman ng trabaho ng Kongreso? Sana pinabayaan na lang ito. Mukhang, pero I believe that OSG Calida has a personal thing with ABS-CBN. Siya, even the President, sabi nga ng Presidente, let the Congress decide with regards to the fate of ABS-CBN.
Congressman Johnny, no, panghuling pagkakataon na lang po bago po tayo magwakas, meron po ba kayong gustong mensaheng ipaabot kay SolGen Calida?
Eh, akin lang naman na Tony, sana naman na pagbigyan naman muna niya ang ABS-CBN ngayon. We already resume our session, and we know that very soon this hearing could continue with regards to the renewal of ABS-CBN. Pagbigyan na muna niya, kasi nasa problema tayo ngayon, nasa crisis tayo ngayon, let us set aside politics, and let us be sober about it. Let us, huwag natin personal ito, because maraming at stake dyan sa ABS-CBN, aside from the people who are working with ABS-CBN, ABS-CBN is already part of the Filipino lives.
All right. Congressman Johnny Pimentel, a representative of Surigao del Sur, 2nd District. Thank you very much, sir, for speaking with us today.